Hi guys, and welcome back to the kind of part two of the HMS Warrior tutorial. This is just going to cover completely with the new sail design. What I've just done at the minute is the way that I lay things out, the way that I actually get my sail design itself is by laying it like this, which doesn't look amazing at the minute. It's very stripped down. So what I'm actually going to do first is I'm just going to tell you kind of how to actually slant the sails themselves, not the sails, the masts, sorry. So all you need to do is, basically I just take the groupings that I have before, you know, if I have like 10 going out or something like that, and I'll change them to a way that I can actually put the sails on a pretty general and similar angle. As you can see from the overview, they're pretty much at the same kind of slant to each other. You also have to make sure that your slant is in line when the sails come out. They actually work with these top sails as well, and also these ones you're going to have to lay out in the correct way so it's actually catching the wind or makes it look like it, otherwise you get it kind of looks a bit odd. So we're just going to start from the back. So what you're going to do is you're going to have three, and then on the left side of the ship what you're going to have is this three here, so it comes forwards and then it goes three backwards. And now the next one. So it's quite difficult to see, I've just been laying out the basis for the sails as well. So you got three, three and three going back, and then you got the three, three, so that one's pretty easy. So then your next one. This time I've got a five in the middle. Then you got three sets of three going off onto the side. So it might actually be easier for me to show you on the opposite side, possibly. So you got, yeah, five, three, 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 like this. And then if we go on to the next sail itself. So what I've got here, we've got a three, three, and three. So the, most of them are built on groups of three, but some of them do differ. Like this one, for example. So yeah, this one has five in the middle. It's got a four, then a four, then a three. The reason that I always, if I do have kind of a weird grouping like this, I always make sure that the biggest one is in the middle, and then it kind of gets smaller as it goes outwards. So that's why I've got the two fours and then a three at the end. So also, that's what that shape's going to be like. And then this one is really big. So this is a seven, four, four, three, and three. Like that. So that's a really big one. And then if we go to the front mast now, so this one's got five and then four on the sides, just like that. And then the next one is five, three, three, three. And this one, seven, four, three, three, three. So I'm just going to show you what I'm actually mean by me counting out all this. So if I go for one of the really easy ones, say this one here. So I'm just going to build it on this one. So you should at the minute have this kind of straight be like this. I'm just going to take off the sails. So this is what you should have. You should just have straight ones. So this one here, when I said it says three and then they're three on the sides, what you're going to do is just going to take off these like this. And make sure that you leave one at least so that you know where it is in relation to it. So it's going to be a three in the middle. And then what you're going to do is you're going to come around the back. And this one will just be slanted backwards. And the other one will be slanted forwards. So all you need to do is just use the data and all the countings that I've just done and told you about on this build. And put that on each of these sails and slant all of the sails. And you can see the difference kind of just on the mini-map anyway. Okay, I can't do that. Yeah, so you can see the difference on the minimap already. It makes it look a little bit more interesting. Even with these basic sails, these very, very square basic sails, it still looks quite cool, though you can see that it's not quite shaped. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to count out these groupings that I've got done for the actual sails themselves, and I'll show you what to do after that. Okay, so for with the sails themselves, what I'm going to do is I'll just show you how to actually go about them. So all I basically do is I've just got these kind of groupings that I use that I'll tell you for each of these sails how to do it. I'll just show you how to do one of them. So this one's got two, three, and then a three. So I'm just going to fly over to this one here just to show you guys how to do it. So what you're going to do is you're just going to come down like this. You got two, and then you're going to come out again. You got three, and then you're going to come in with a three as well. So sometimes, and kind of most often, you do have to actually cut into, is that even right? So most often you do have to cut into these side bits to get it to work kind of properly. And then all you're going to do is just going to bring, as the mouse goes forwards, you just bring this pattern forwards. So this one, what you're going to have to do is, actually I could have left that in. So yeah, so you just can leave some of it in. Sometimes you will cut into the crow's nest, I did on mine. Because the original build, this one was basically supposed to be just tied up. But now that I've come up with a cool sail design, I've decided to put that in as a part two that you're getting now. So all you're going to do is just go around. Now, with this bit, what I did is I cut this one out and put it there so it just connects into the sail. And all you're going to do, again, like this. And this gets your basic sail. I will show you after I've counted them all out and you guys have put in all of these sails on yours. I will show you how to make it look really, really awesome. So that's what you're going to get when I'm telling you what to do on the patterns. Yeah. So starting from the back one, we've got a 2, 3, and a 3, which is the one we just did over there. Next one is a 2, 4, and a 2. And the next one is 3, 3, 2. Just like that. So I've already missed on one, so I need to add that on in a bit. And then the next one we have is 3, 3, 3, 2, and then a 1. So this one's a little bit different just because I had to try and get it to wrap around into the actual mast itself. And then the next one we have is 3, 3, 3, 3. So it just goes out 3 times, then goes in once. So this one isn't touching at all. And the next one is 2, 3, 3, and then goes in for 2. Just like that. You could make it longer, but I wanted a 3 block gap kind of to walk around, because it does feel a little bit better when you have 3 blocks to walk around anyway. But it's kind of up to you if you want to do it that way or if you want to do it slightly different. And then this one is a 2, 3, 3, 2, and then a 1. And then the next is 3, 3, 3, 2, and 1. And the last one is 2, 3, 2, 2. And again, this was just to make the 3 block gap where you can walk around really happily. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to do, because there's 9 of these in total, but the style that I use is exactly the same on all of them. So I'm going to show you guys how to do just one of the sails. I'll choose probably this sail here, the kind of bigger one, so I can really show you how to do it. And then all you have to do is copy the same idea of doing it. That's the main thing I want you guys to kind of learn from this, is the way to actually go about the sails, or the way that I've gone about the sails anyway. I mean, there's an infinite way of doing sails, really, but this is the kind of way that I'll show you kind of how it works. So let's do it. Okay, another thing just before I get onto that sail part, you will have to cut out absolutely masses of this back kind of rigging here. I'm just going to finish this off as well while I'm talking to you guys about this. Yeah, unfortunately, because I didn't plan to actually have it with the sails, I didn't really make any of the rigging or anything like that to actually specifically work with it, so I'm just trying to make it so it kind of fudges it. So you do lose quite a lot. Just leave the bits that are on the back, but it's better to put in the kind of white wool than it is the rigging itself, because the rigging, you know, if it was different on both sides, you wouldn't really notice, but the sails are kind of a little bit more as an important feature. So make sure that you kind of make sure that you get all these in. And also on these, I think what I'm going to do is just have the fence just connecting right into the sails itself. It might be a bit easier. Right, so let's get on to building a sail. Okay, so this is the kind of thing that we're going to work on now, which is this style of sails. They're just kind of advanced from those squares there are basically what I use for the bases, and then it really, really simply actually turns into this crazy mesh that you see now. So I've done the front 3 of them. I haven't done these middle ones. I'm only going to do one of these sails, and then they are all exactly the same. And I've also done the back ones here. So you can kind of see how different it is from this sails here, which look quite square and a bit boring, to this kind of very complex. It looks really difficult. It's not at all. So now we're going to just do one of these ones. And then we've got all these side sails to do. But most of those will be pretty similar anyway. So it's got 1, 2, 3. And we've got a couple at the front as well to get done. We've got 3 going down the front to do. So let's do this main sail now. So now that you've got this kind of basic square kind of thing, all we're going to do is we're going to eliminate the straight lines and make it a bit more curved. So you can see on this, you can hardly see any kind of boxes or anything like that. You can see a couple of boxes here. But what I would do is do this a bit later on anyway. You kind of constantly end up chipping out of it and making it look a little bit better. So I'm just going to choose this. I'll do this higher one, and then I'll do the bigger one as well, just to show you the difference between the smaller ones and the bigger ones. There's not really any difference. So the main thing you need to do, this is not going to be a direct tutorial of how to do it. It's going to be more of a how to go about doing it. It's going to be teaching you guys how to do it. So you've got all these straight lines in here, and they look pretty horrible. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take out these ones and place a block like this. So already that's taking out that edge a bit. I've already added one on there. I'm going to take these ones out as well, like that. So sometimes you do have to cut into bits of the actual, you know, the bits that are behind. So there we go. So that's softened that out a bit. I'm also going to take out just a couple of these, a bit randomly. So there we go. I can only have one on that one because the master's there. And I'm just going to move this one back. So you can see the top layer's already started to look pretty cool. And now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to add one there. I'm just going to add two in this part. Come under here. I'm going to add two here as well. And then just one in this bit. I'm just going to add one in the middle of each of these, just as a kind of basis. Like that. So that's already started to look quite cool. And then again, eliminating this kind of edge here. So we're just going to add in them like that. And then we've got them kind of, because we've got this one underneath, it is a bit more difficult, which is why I wanted to do this one. But we just need to try and make them kind of connect together a little bit better. So there we go. That doesn't look too bad already. I'm already going to just chip out this one there, and actually down there as well. So there we go. So that gets our basic bit. We've got this kind of 3x3 square, which I don't like, so I'm just going to add one on the top like that. Most of what I do is I make sure you've kind of got this way around it on these forwardmost parts. So now what we're going to do is these bits that come off it, I'm still not amazingly good at these, but what we're just going to do is just come back and I'm just going to add a couple of blocks. I kind of try and make it look alright and then just try and curve it a little bit. So that doesn't look too bad. Most of these, the best way to do it is just by randomly placing blocks, which sounds a bit odd. So there we go. So now what you want to do, when you've got two of these bits, you've got this one up here and you've got this one down here, what you want to do is try and curve them to get, like, curve them in. So I'm just going to add, no, I'm going to take that away. So I'm going to do this. There we go, right. So I'm trying to create a curve which is not working at all at the minute. Okay. Yeah, it has to be there. So bring this one back. So I'm going to try and bring this one back. Let's bring this back a little bit like that. And create the curve in here, maybe. That's not too bad. Let me take this one out there. So that's not terribly bad. It's not amazing either. I'm just going to extend this one a little bit. It looks a bit small. So there we go. That's kind of like a first one. It's not the best one. And I'm going to take this one out and put one in here. There we go, so that's kind of roughly how I do it. And they do the other side, of course, exactly the same. So again, I've just chipped out another one. You always keep on seeing them. As soon as you start doing a few of these, you just start kind of noticing things. I'll go that way. And I'm going to come down. Have one behind here. I don't know why I just chipped out. One there. On this bit, I pull this one back. So this, come in. Here. Be there. How's that look? So that side already looks a lot better than this one. So you do find that sometimes another one kind of works this way. Works out just a little bit better. There we go. So that's the first kind of way. That's the way that I kind of do all of them. And you can see how simple it is from going from this. It's a really easy way of setting them out. You know, you do the mast in a certain way, you do these sails in a certain way, and then you just kind of turn that into this really easily. So I'm now going to do this one as well as part of the tutorial, and then you guys can copy it to all of those 9 and we'll get onto the side bits. Okay, so let's do this middle one. So yet again, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to look over it, and you can see all these straight lines, so I'm just going to eliminate these right away like this. Just cut them out, cut them out, cut them out. And I'm going to cut these ones out as well. Put in the blocks. This is just for the rough shaping of it. This one's quite a bit bigger, so it's going to be quite difficult. I'm going to come around the back of this mast here. Just like this. Okay, and then I'm going to cut out these ones, put in a block behind. Just like this. So it's kind of... it does change. Every single time I do this, it's always different. Always different. So you can see that I'm just trying to shape it a bit randomly. There we go. So then I've got one down here. I'm going to cut out this one as well. I'm going to cut out these ones now, like that. Just to make it different. Keep that one. Maybe cut out this one. No, I want to keep that one. I'm going to cut out this one instead. And then make this 2, so it's... this is mainly just trying to give you guys an idea of what I do to make these sails rather than a specific tutorial. Right, let's have a look at that. So there we go, so you can see the bottom layer is still not done, but the top part actually looks pretty good. I'm just going to take this one, put that on there. Actually, I'm going to extend this one more. The reason I'm doing that is because I've got this one in line here. It just looks a little bit too straight. It looks like I've just copied it off the underside. There we go. A bit more random. And I need to cut out this one as well. It's really square. So I'm going to cut out those two. Bring this one back. I'm just going to do a rough bit like that for the time being, and then bring this up. Story starting on that curve. Cut this one, put that one down there. And cut out this one, so bring this across like the bottom. And then just join this one in here, in here. Like this, right. Right, let's have a look. So it's starting to get there. I've still got these boxes here, like this 2 and a 2. Just don't like. So I'm just going to get rid of those. Also up here, it looks a bit too straight and everything. So I'm just going to go around here and do one of these bits. And again, that looks too straight, so I'm just going to do this there. That goes around to this part. Just gonna bring this a bit more, thicken this a bit up. That's not too bad. This one needs to be longer. This maybe. There then. Instead, maybe. There we go. So that's not too bad. So I've just got these other 2 side bits to do. Or I've got one here, but I might just extend this one a bit. It's a bit too straight, I think. Like this, maybe, and this one at the top, so I'm just going to bring this one around to this, here and here, bring this around and up, and then come in like that, maybe. So there we go, hopefully you guys have kind of got the idea of how to turn these ones in. It does happen very randomly, but all you need to do is just eliminate those kind of straight, these kind of right angles, the 90-degree angles, is what you really don't want on this. So copy that onto all of those 9 sails, or you can do that later, of course. Oh, actually, I have just forgotten, you need to cut all these as well. So before you do all that, to make them, because basically the sails have these curves that go in on the sides, and they also have it kind of going on this bit here. So what you're going to do is just come to the middle, and you just cut out a few blocks, kind of at random. I'm kind of going to keep that one in. No, I'm not. Definitely not going to keep that one in. I'm just going to cut out a couple of those. There we go. And then the same on the bottom as well. So you're just going to cut out the bottom. And I usually do this after I've actually finished the design itself. There we go. So I'm already changing the cell design as I'm doing it, just to make it fit. I'll have taken out one too many there. There we go. So you're kind of cutting out those bits as well, to make these kind of different bowed bits. So I'm just going to do it on this one as well. Like this, and then on the bottom. Like that. Okay, so how does that look? That doesn't look too bad at all. So that's how you go about doing those 9 main sails. You can copy this kind of way of doing it to every single build that I do that I haven't done the sails in. But from now on, I'm going to be teaching these sail designs, or I might just make a general sails video. But if you guys get stuck, don't hesitate to comment on this part. And I will make a general sales tutorial, which will be really, really heavily in depth. So let's get onto these side bits here, because there's 3 of these in total. There's one at the back, which will be slightly different, and we've got these ones. I haven't built these side things before, so I'm actually going to be building them with you in real time, giving you ideas. So let's do it. Okay, so once you've kind of done your sales, you should have something similar to this. But obviously you're going to have a completely different kind of style type thing just because you've done it yourself as well, so you're going to have your own unique style. So we're going to start on these kind of slanted sails first. There's 3 of them in total. I haven't done them before, so it's going to be interesting to see what I kind of come up with these. So it's mainly going to be giving you ideas of how to do them. So I've already done, I've just kind of put down on each of these 2s, just going across like this, and I've got it on this side because we've got the sails here, so the wind would be pushing from this kind of direction as we got the slant there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to join all of these ones up as well, place down, and then I'm going to come forwards and I'm going to do exactly the same. I'm just going to wrap these ones around it like this. Coming forwards as well, just a little bit like that. And then I'm going to do the same again. Like that. So you can see I've just added a couple extra blocks here. I'm just doing a little bit more than last time. I'm just going to add a bit more of a zigzag into some of these. Add a couple bit more. So now I'm just going to have a look at it. So I'm kind of getting what I want, sort of. So now I'm going to come in slightly, just for a 2 layers maybe, like this, and then it's going to get shorter as it goes to the top here, like that, or I might bring this one here, not too sure. Like with most of these ones, it is a bit more trial and error. There we go, we've got that. Maybe bring this behind. Here, and here. And I'm just going to connect to one layer that gets into the bottom here. So I'm going to connect in there, maybe. Just looking at it now. Make this one a bit bigger, maybe. And take this one out. So I'm still not happy with this one at all. So come behind with those there, and then take out this square there. And I want to try and curve this one down this way. What I'm just going to do is just grab a couple of these, make a rough kind of outline of what I want, and then pull these ones back. Like that, I think. I do want these going right there. Okay, let's have a look at that. That's kind of getting there. This bit's now too big, so I'm going to have to pull these bits of the sail down as well. And also I've got this straight kind of line here, which I don't like. So I might just do that instead. And then fill in this bit again. Let's put these down, so let's have a look at that. So there we go, that's a rough kind of idea. It's not perfect by any means. I'm actually going to still pull down these ones here as well. And then I'm going to pull down these ones. So you do have to really keep on kind of flying backwards with this to try and get a rough feel. That's not too bad now. It's starting to get there. And I'm just going to make this bit that sticks out a bit bigger. Like this. And put one there and one there. So there you go. So that's kind of a rough idea for it. I'm not amazing at these cells, so now let's get on to the next one. So I'm going to do exactly the same kind of style anyway. But it will be a bit smaller, so I'm just going to connect these on. Again, I've done the twos going across here, so you've got this two connecting in to that part. And then what we're going to do is we're going to come out and come down like this. And this one will be a lot smaller. So I'm actually already just going to add on a couple extra blocks into this. And then we're going to come back inside, so it's really small, this one. Like that. Here we go. Put it down. Let's have a look at that. So it's not too bad. I need to get it to connect into here as well, so I'm just going to put an extra layer on some of these bits coming behind. Like that, maybe. And add on in there. Or actually add in like that. There we go. So that hasn't turned out too badly actually at all, but it's not terrible. I might actually just extend this bit up here as well, and like this, and then try and make it look like it's actually got a bit of a curve, so I need to just add an extra block here maybe. Okay, so that doesn't look too bad. So copy this design onto this one here, it'll be pretty similar, so just try and get it to connect into that fence we got down there, and then we'll get onto the three front ones. Okay, so this is the second one that I kind of came up with for this front one that you guys shouldn't have any problem with. It's not perfect, my one isn't perfect at all, I'm already still playing with it a bit, so it's not, you know, it doesn't have to be perfect with these kind of sails. It's actually probably best to be slightly imperfect. So there we go, so that's what I kind of came up with. So now what we're going to do is we're going to move on to these three kind of really large sails that move down kind of downwards. So I'm just going to set up for them. All I'm going to do is just put in white pieces of wool on these parts like this. Just like this. So let's just keep on going. Oh, there. Okay, so let's have a look at that. So that's not too bad. I could add a couple extra on the front, I think, or just one extra on the front. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to join them up. Just like this. That's not too bad. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come out finally. So like this, just coming out. And I'm just going to do a squiggle pattern, just joining them up. And going all the way down to the bottom, like this. Okay, and I'm going to go one more. Right, so that one needs this one here, I think, can probably be one thicker. So I just add an extra block. Unfortunately, these ones do always look really, they don't look as nice as these ones. So I guess I've added that, and I'm just going to do one layer of squiggling around, going forwards, and then I'm going to start working my way back, and hopefully that will work out. Like this. There we go. Making the way down. There. And there. And then I'm going to work my way back in again. Okay, what does that look like? So it doesn't look too bad, but these are always quite difficult. And then all I'm going to do is just come in on the back part and just put in a block on these fences to finish it off. Right, let's have a look at this. So now what I want to do is I want to make a curve from here going to here, so I'm just going to add an extra couple blocks there, cut out there, and then cut out these, cut them behind. So there we go, that's not too bad. So that's actually, no, that's alright actually, that's got a curve there. And I kind of want a curve from here going down to here. So I'm just going to put in the basis for kind of basic bits here. Let's put in that. There we go. So that wasn't too difficult at all. So then just copy this style of doing it. It's up to you if you want to have this way of doing it, or if you want to add a couple extra blocks and actually move, have this one as the middle bit, which is actually what I'm going to do. It's kind of up to you. The sails are very, very difficult to teach, mainly because they can be very complicated. If I did this block by block, this video would be at least like 3 hours long, I think. So it'd be like longer than the actual main tutorial. So there we go, that looks a little bit better. So copy this one onto this top one. And I'm going to have a go at coming up with something for the bottom one. It's going to be based off this, but I'm going to try and make a kind of circular bit here. So let's do it. Okay, so this is what I came up for the front three sails. The big one is just a bigger version of this smaller one that I went through with you guys. And then the bottom one, all I did for this one is I tried to create kind of like a triangle going across here. And I just used a couple of bits of fence to connect it into the next kind of sail here. So we're almost done. Just got to do this kind of front bit now. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just kind of curve it, so I'm just going to have a look at this thing we got. Right, so what we can do is we can have four of them going back, I think. This. So you got five in the middle, then four back. Five in the middle. And let's not have four going forwards like this. And then what I'm going to do is just grab my wool, come down. I'm just going to do two with this one, just for this layer here. And then go across, of course, like that, and down. And then we're going to go out for a three. Yeah, we'll go out for a three. Like this. It's quite easy. Like that, and then in for two. So it's going to be quite easy. It's going to be exactly the same way that we did the large sails as well. So I'm just going to chip them out. Of course, it'll be a lot faster because it's a lot smaller as the sail itself. So just doing this, this, cutting out this one. I'll just bring this one back. Like that. Add one there. Cutting out just that one now. Up here. This and like that, right? And then down on the bottom one as well. Right, let's have a look. So now what we need to do is just shape this one a little bit better. So I'm gonna lock in here and lock in here, I think. So this front one isn't my best at all, but you'll kind of get a rough idea. And then exactly the same as we did, we're just gonna cut out some of the middle blocks and some of the upper blocks as well. So we might just cut out a few of the upper blocks. And I've got this kind of really big square here, so I'm just gonna try and round it off just a bit. So I'm just gonna add an extra block here, maybe. Cut this and put in one there, and then cut that one out there. Once you keep that one in, do that. So there we go, so that's the front one. Now all you need to do to kind of finish it off is around all of the back parts underneath the actual piece itself. You just need to put in fence on these bits. So just to kind of finish this off, it finishes off the kind of back look of the sail. You won't do it on these slanted ones, of course. You can do it on this one, on some parts of it, I think. You can do it on every other one. Or you can do it connected in like this, which is the way I'm going to do it, like that. So these ones, again, what you're going to do is just put your kind of fencing behind. I always do this last, because when you start cutting out the sails and things like that, otherwise it will just get too complicated. Like that, so do that on all of those, and then there's only one more thing that we can really do to this build just to finish it up. So all you'd need to do then is grab your cobwebs and just kind of have some smoke coming out of them with these, and you've got to try and get it to somehow work around all your fences as well. So we have this coming up. And that looks terrible, but I'm sure you guys can kind of come up with a nice big cloud type thing. As I'm not great at this. There we go, some random blocks. See if this makes it any better. So there we go, that's a little bit better, I think. So you got some smoke there, and I can just see what I need to knock out. There. So then you can do that on both of these as well, so you've got both of those. You could do it on the smaller ones, but I'd recommend just doing it on the big ones. And that completes the HMS Warrior with all of the sails as well. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this part 2, going over the advanced sail design. If you did, make sure you comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next mega tutorial.